flies, Natasha. That sounded weird, but anyway.
It did sound weird. So let's move on.
Let's do that.
Let's pretend that you didn't say
okay. that. Okay. Well, some nice weather to do all sorts of things outside, right? In some spots.
Indeed. Yes. Yes. I'm going to take you out to Stoller Winery right now. It is 55 degrees out here. Look at how green it is. Yeah. Just talking about planting and the season and whatnot. The little bit of rain that we have had certainly has made things much greener. That is a good sign. We love seeing the signs of greenery out there, but we need a little bit more rain. We're still behind for the month. When we look at our month to date totals, we're still under just an inch despite the rain that we've recently had. Okay, so we head out to our Subaru camera looking to the south, and we have a little bit of blue sky out there. Sure looks nice. But for the most part, today has been a mostly cloudy kind of day, 58 degrees. Wind right now is pretty light out of the north at just 3 miles per hour. Temperatures for you tonight will be in the mid 50s going into about 8 o'clock, and then we'll eventually move into the upper 40s just before midnight. We're going to see a range of conditions. We're going to clear out those clouds, but as soon as we do, that also increases our chance of seeing some fog develop for us overnight. So talking about fog possibly tomorrow in the morning for some parts of the valley, not widespread, but patchy fog is possible. We're going to stay cool for the next couple of days, see a brief increase in our temperatures, then go back down to below normal temperatures for the end of the week. And also a series of storms coming through, which means after we get through tomorrow, every day this week, we might be seeing some rain, at least something measurable every day going into the weekend. So here's our next front on the way. It looks rather impressive as we look at our satellite and radar imagery. So with this first system, we'll see rain arrive at the coast by tomorrow night, and then we're looking at our best chance at seeing some of that rain move into the picture as we get into early Wednesday morning. Here our chance of rain increases as soon as we get past midnight. You can see it goes from not so likely to scattered showers developing for us as we get into early Wednesday morning and continuing all the way through Thursday and beyond that point as well. So let's take a look at our extended forecast. So we're clearing the clouds out tonight, patchy fog in the morning. Next chance of rain that arrives for us as we get to early Wednesday. And initially it's going to be the light variety for the valley. The higher totals are really going to go to the coastline again. As we get to Wednesday, part of the day, especially south of Portland, you get a little bit of a break from the rain. Next series comes through late Thursday into Friday, lasting again all the way through the weekend, not getting much of a break in between these systems. So what does that mean for rainfall totals? What does that look like? Well, let's just go all the way into Friday morning. By Friday, at that point, it's going to take a couple of days for us to even collect an inch of rain inland. At the coast, it might be upwards of about an inch and a half. Of course, east of the Cascades, you're looking at less than half an inch of rain. Now, if we add in the weekend's totals, we could be getting closer to about 2 inches total in the valley. What does that look like for the coast? Now we're getting closer to 3 inches possible. Again, the highest totals will be out towards the northwest Washington into areas right around Forks. Okay, 7-day forecast looks like this. So tomorrow, looking pretty good. Temperatures will be in the mid to upper 60s, low to mid 60s as we get to Thursday. Then Friday, we're a little bit cooler heading into the weekend, mid 50s and rain. So I don't know if you guys are sensitive to the lack of sunshine, but I'm getting out that UV light as we get to this weekend because I need a little bit of artificial vitamin D when we get into these systems.
Oh, yeah, those are handy.
I'm sensitive about a lot of things.
He is. Yeah, let's not get started on that. Okay.